A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 19th August, on the front page you have curbs on movements back in Kashmir following clashes. So there have been curbs on movement established again, reimposed in parts of Srinagar after violent overnight clashes between residents and the police, which left dozens injured, two senior officials were, and eyewitnesses have said. So the decision to allow internet and mobile phone use in parts of Jammu region was also reversed, and now there are concerns of the spread of rumors. That's why mobile connectivity has been blocked. In the past 24 hours, it is said there have been series of protests against the abrogation of Article 370, and after easing of restrictions on movement and phone use, the protests have emerged. It is said 4,000 have been detained. 4,000 people have been detained in Kashmir over fears of unrest. Then this is any talks with Pakistan only on POK. So Defense Minister Rajnath Singh said that Pakistan talks would focus only on status of Pakistan occupied Kashmir, not Jammu and Kashmir under Indian control. So we have seen how Pakistan has cut off its relation with India and has approached the UN as such too on the abrogation of Article 370 in Jammu and Kashmir by India. Then this is India and Bhutan are natural partners. So this is what Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said on a visit to Bhutan, that we are natural partners. He was addressing the students of the Royal University of Bhutan. So we have seen how various MOUs have also been signed between India and Bhutan yesterday. Then this is 63 killed in blast at Kabul wedding. Islamic State claims responsibility. So Islamic State has claimed responsibility for the suicide blast at a wedding reception in Afghanistan that killed 63 people. So such attacks continue in Afghanistan. Taliban is having talks with US government too, even with the Afghan government, but and US wants Taliban to have no relations with Islamic State. But here you can see Islamic State has conducted such attacks in Afghanistan now. On page 6 you have Odisha to conserve two of its largest lakes. So Odisha Wetland Authority has approved implementation of an integrated management plan for Chilika, which is the country's largest brackish water lagoon, and Ansupa, which is Odisha's largest freshwater lake. So it will be an estimated investment of 180 crore rupees. A 5-year management of lakes is intended to be implemented. This would strengthen livelihood of thousands of fishermen relying on the two water bodies to also promote tourism and conserve the ecology. So you should know about these two lakes, Chilika and Ansupa. Then on page 7 you have, in a first, Pune Metro to get aluminium bodied coaches. So this is for Indian Metro, first time that aluminium bodied state of the art coaches, ultra modern coaches would be provided. So this is for Pune Metro. So it was a tender floated by Maharashtra Metro. So here you can see it's Maharashtra Metro Rail Corporation Limited. So this tender, international tender to supply 102 aluminium coaches to Pune Metro project has been won by Titagar Wagons, which is a wholly owned subsidiary of Titagar Pharma SPL. So the state-of-the-art aluminium bodied coaches would be provided. Till so far, all metro coaches in India are stainless steel bodied. Then this is Doctors Federation pushes to check hysterectomy rates. So high rate of hysterectomy in Bid district in Maharashtra has put medical fraternity in a spot that why unwanted procedures are being carried out. Hysterectomy, you should know, is an operation which is conducted to in the uterus. The uterus is removed so that woman cannot conceive. So it is a requirement to sensitize the members for treatment other than surgery. There are treatments other than surgery which can be undertaken. In many cases, such operations, when they fail, they result in further complications. So this is a cause of concern, you should know, because B district is a drought-stricken district in Marathwada, and it came in focus in May 2019 when media reports highlighted large number of women, especially those who migrated for sugarcane cutting work, have had their uterus removed. There have been 4,605 hysterectomies which were carried out in Bid in 3 years in 99 private hospitals. On the editorial page, the first editorial is unclear doctrine. So this is regarding no first use principle of nuclear weapons, which India has. It's part of India's nuclear doctrine, no first use policy. So it is said this is integral to India's nuclear doctrine and leaves no space for ambiguity. So this is in the context that we saw in news yesterday, Defense Minister Rajnath Singh had said that no first use principle of India's nuclear policy is not rigid. So what does it imply is a cause of concern. And this is taking on TB. So this is regarding new drugs which have also been, you know, found for extremely drug resistant TB. So keeping the prices of the new drug low is essential for increased treatment uptake is what this editorial tries to emphasize. The lead article, the idea of India is failing. So this article says that the middle class that led India's nation building project has now embraced a nationalism that has no place for diversity. So this is in the context of even how in Jammu and Kashmir, fundamental rights have been suspended and Article 370 has been abrogated, and even after relaxation of restraints, when clashes emerged, the restrictions have again been reinforced. And this is an intervention that led to more questions. So this is regarding revocation of no first use policy, which is being spoken of now. The editorial article is also on that. It says revoking no first use does not necessarily mean giving up restraint, but it leaves India's nuclear doctrine more ambiguous. So that's the key point which is being made. On a UPSC page, again, there's an article on Jammu and Kashmir. It says a lose-lose scenario. It says that center's action plans for Jammu and Kashmir suffer from inherent infirmities. So because what it intends to achieve cannot be achieved by such actions is what the article tries to say, a lose-lose scenario. And then this is regarding witness protection, a law for those who testify. So it says the center is yet to act on Supreme Court directive to legislate on witness protection. So this law has not yet been brought in by the government. On page 12, you have here public sector banks told to align with national priorities. So center has asked public sector banks to burn the midnight oil, means to work hard over this weekend and next weekend and align themselves with the national priorities. So feedbacks would be sought from them on several issues such as rise in bad loans, low credit growth in the past 5 years, and they would be asked to prepare a roadmap for the coming years. So this is there. Then on page 13, you have Army looking to tweak disability pension criteria. So the Army, Navy and Air Force, three services are putting together recommendations on the issue of taxing disability pension to be and this will be submitted to the Defense Ministry very soon. So there are several options to streamline the existing system for grant of disability pension and the manner of calculation of disability pension. So the Army has written to two other services and put forward some suggestions which would now be discussed. So this disability pension had come up in news that how it has been taxed. So here you can see an unsigned Army letter had also emerged which said that the Army itself had recommended taxation of disability pension because it has been misused. But then disability pension is awarded in the first place by the Army itself. So why would it allow it to be misused? Then on the international page, you have this coverage on Afghanistan. We saw in news how Islamic State has claimed responsibility for this terror attack in which more than 60 people were killed. So this is the news. Then below you have Gibraltar rejects request to seize Iranian tanker. So Gibraltar has refused US request to seize Iranian tanker caught in standoff between Iran and Britain. So this vessel as such, which raised an Iranian flag ahead of its expected departure from the British territory, is what US has not liked. So this is, you can see, the tanker in Gibraltar, which was seized in July on suspicion that it was carrying oil to Syria. Syria is a close ally of Iran. So this was violation of European Union sanctions. So there were conflicts and, you know, standoff escalated. But now you can see that Gibraltar has released this Iranian tanker, though USA wanted it to be seized. Then there is no important news on business page, and last page also has sports news. So these were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com, where PDFs for current affairs will be uploaded daily now from now on. Thank you.